It's the regular yeast, that's the regular dry yeast.
Regular. Well, this one, maybe it's a little special, it's not tampered, it's organic.
Yes, okay. Organic.
Because
yeah.
You have other yeast that is being sold that I used to use, but I'm sort of moving away from it.
Yeah.
All right, so we have our mixing bowl, and what we need now, what I'm actually doing, just for the sake of the toaster oven, if I make it a regular size, it's gonna burn the rice.
Yeah.
So I'm actually half my ingredients so that I can have the ingredients in there. So if you want to bake a bigger bread, you can multiply by two and then you can for your regular size. What
one, two, three, four, five.
I have water.
Dried yeast.
Warm water. And and then I'm gonna be adding my recipe.
No, this sweet. This sweet. Yeah.
2 cups of spelt flour.
Want to see her? You can see?
Yes, it's not
coming together.
No, not
like something like that is a fraud, and people will say it looks like it's fitting water.
Alright, so I'm going to be adding that, and then I'm going to add my 1 cup of flour, and I'm going to do the other one. Your hands need to be clean because I'm going to be using my hands. I wash my hands a million times a while ago.
When I get it cooking, it's like this. I'm not trying to get the person, but my dad used to tell me, no matter how you wash your hands, when you use it in the thing, when you finish your hands, get them to clean.
When you realize the spoon can't do it anymore, it's time for your hands. Be putting two of these normally in the normal mixture before you half it. I would have put 1/8 cup of olive oil. So I'm putting 2 tablespoons.
What time are the red then?
Normally I put this in the mixture itself before I put in the flour.
You should put it from the
pan. It's working, you know, it's not too late.
You know, this is kind of the same way you make pizza dough.
Same way you make the pizza dough. Just have to put less yeast in there.
Pizza too.
I was thinking about it, but
I make pizza too.
Yeah, because I was gonna. I actually worked with some cheese that I made this morning. So
wait, you made the cheese?
Yeah. I make cheese. I make the tomato. Piece.
Tomato sauce.
Make the pizza from scratch.
Well, I thought I was doing it, but apparently I wasn't. I buy the cheese from the store.
Well, after today,
no,
you're
going to be using my hands now.
With pizza, you may leave it to rise, you don't leave rice for 5 minutes, at least rise for like overnight. So how long do you need it for?
You need it until everything comes up to in a ball, and then I'm gonna cover it and leave it to rise for 15 minutes. And when you double rise your bread, it tastes better. So I'm actually giving it a double rise. I'm gonna let it rise for 15 minutes, and then when I actually put it in a container that I'm gonna be baking it, I'm gonna let it stay for another 20 minutes or so. If you can go to half an hour.
So like there's not gonna be food like the
music.
So it's not a matter of how long you need for, it's just a matter until everything come together.
It doesn't matter how much you need it for. Just make sure everything come together, but the rising is important.
I'm just gonna rise it, just like a common cup.
The spelt flour has gluten.
The spelt flour has gluten, okay. But it's just a healthy, it's just a healthier flour. So you can have a lot of things to do at home, and while the bread is rising, you're doing some other things.
Like
if you're doing a pizza, they can be doing their cheese on the side. So we're going to keep this here now to rise.
1 minute is a bad.
So we're going to give it for
15.
But brother boy, if you're doing it at home, it depends on the amount of heat in your house. It will rise faster.
Mm-hmm.
If the temperature is cooler, it takes a longer time. So it gets warm. Yes, give it that loaf.
Sounds hollow.
or you get the oven spring when you touch it.
And you do, when you, the first time I bake bread, when I bake the bread, I'm saying, my God, the bread's spoiled. Look at the thing, tough man. And you see, when it comes out of the oven and it starts cooling it down, it just starts getting relaxed. It's relaxing and gets soft.
Yes. You just knock it so it have a hollow sound. It's hollow sound. And it's the oven spring.
Agar powder.
That you can buy.
Thicken it.
So you know, Brother Scott, that the mozzarella cheese is from the cow, the goat, the donkey, and the sheep. And there is a special process that is not healthy for consumption. And this cheese is tastier and more nutritious.
And that's
how that one is.
And the thing is, you went to the store, saw that it says lactose free, so that kind of.
Yeah. Well, and there is no lactose free from the animal, yeah? They are lying.
So I think I may try it before I actually go on. It wasn't asking if I
could be.
Yeah,
you're more worth the lactose free for the
mozzarella. Because
you
want to be made as well.
So they look at dinner rolls that you would see, right? Mm-hmm. So when they put together, they're going to stick together, and fluff up, and you just tear them apart.
What is that?
I have to do it every semester. Just like potato bread, cornmeal bread. Yes, or you can twist it, or you can braid it.
You could do it in a one
piece. Put four in.
Yeah, that's a loaf.
Sometimes you're kneading it, you actually feel the bubbles in it. You just sort of press it out so that you don't get the bread with that air space in it. You want it to raise evenly.
Should I get married? She getting married?
Yes.
She's sweet.
Our chief wiping her.
Alright, so we're going to give it the half an hour now. So we're timing half an hour from now.
So you will see it.
This is the second rice. I didn't give it all the time because I realized we're going to be time problem. Alright, so